going to talk about the PBE tool, and Adam's been kind of the key developer of the back end behind this, kind of a library of functions called Pelican. So go ahead, Adam.
Thank you, Greg. Can you hear me well?
Yep.
Okay. Welcome, everyone. Greg already introduced me, so if you don't mind, I would just blaze on and try to get this done. We are already on at the time that we want it to be when we finish this. So I'm going to talk about the PBE tool, performance-based engineering tool, and I'm going to focus on highlighting a few points from the assignment that we have for you in the end of this workshop, and trying to encourage you to choose this assignment over the other two, because you know you will have to choose one of the first three, and it's a tough competition. The PBE tool is interesting, I think, because it provides you an option to have the entire workflow going from building a model, selecting earthquakes, running a response simulation, and then doing loss assessment. All of this is in one tool. The PBE tool is built off of the EEUQ tool, so whatever Quanshi told you is available here. And most of the things that Akash told you about in the CoFEM tool is also available in a PBE, and you can use it in a performance assessment context. But having said that, you don't have to do the entire workflow. You can also decide that you have an external tool, as you will see in the example that I give you as an assignment. You can have an external response simulation and bring it in and only focus on the performance assessment part, which is actually turning out to be really helpful in graduate education. You can choose a particular learning objective and focus only on that, so students don't have to understand the entire workflow. They can only focus on certain pieces of the model, and you can provide them the other pieces of information. So moving on, looking at the particular assignment that I have in the attached files for you at the end of the workshop, we are looking at the frame structure, and we will that is located in Los Angeles, and we will bring in structural analysis results from an external calculation and then calculate damage and losses for the structure using FEMA P58 methodology. A couple of highlights on this analysis. The structural model is one of those famous Hazelton frames. The whole example is from FEMA P58. So this is an example that is heavily documented and is available in the FEMA P58 background documentation. And I use that documentation to create an input file for you that you can load into the application, and everything is populated. So you will see all the settings that are required to run this example. And I provide a description that shows you which settings turned out to be really helpful or useful in educational settings also. This frame was simulated by Kurt Hazelton about 15 or 10 years ago. And then we take his simulation results and format them in a table like this so that we can load it into PBE. This is a really simple way to describe the results of a simulation over a number of ground motions, producing a number of different EDPs. And then we also have another table that describes the component quantities. Again, a really simple way, if you think about communicating with students, to list all the different components that are in the building, describe where they are in terms of floors or other types of locations, which direction they are excited in, and how much of them are in the building. You can do this in such a table, or you can also do it in the user interface. Both of them work, and you can save whatever you did in the interface or load the table in really easily. Once you set up everything and run the analysis, PBE itself provides an overview of the results with histograms and joint distribution plots like these of many decision variables that you might be interested in. But if you are a researcher and you want to go deeper and you want to understand what happened to each performance group in the building, we also provide CSV files that you can use in post-processing to learn about the EDPs, the component quantities, the damage states, or the decision variables for each performance group. And I have a slide with all kinds of links that you can use to learn more about this tool in the end. Thank you.
Okay, well thanks, Adam. And I do want to, we want to go on, but before we do that, I just want to pause.